So, Lair for the PlayStation 3. And this was a game that was really hyped up before its release. You know, this just goes gonna be this epic dragon game. You fly around a dragon, you knock stuff out, and you fight against other dragons, and it's just gonna be this really cool epic dragon game coming developed by Factor 5, who made Rogue Squadron games on the N64, where it was just a really fun flight simulation title. So it's kind of the same genre, developed by the same people. So and then on the PS3, which at the time was hyped up to be this massive beast of a machine. So there was a lot of hype, but of course we all know how it ended. And the ending is that Lair turned out to be the most bashed PS3 game, undoubtedly, I think. It's everyone really just gave a lot of flack and just a lot of was really negative towards Lair. A lot of which, you know, I don't find the complaints that the controls are unresponsive. I don't find that to be true for me. But regardless of that, I do think Lair really deserved the bad press it got. Not because, you know, the controls are bad or anything, or that it's a horrible game, which I don't think it is, but just because of the marketing the design decision. You know, if you decide to make a game with a motion controls or whatever, and there it is possible to control the game. Now, people are used to playing flight simulation games with a joystick or a controller, what have you, and you're gonna do it with motion controllers. I mean, you should have at least given an option for the players. And I know they wanted to really kind of sell the marketing aspect of the motion controllers. So maybe that's why they didn't, you know, make it an option to do a dual analog. But even so, if they didn't do that, maybe they should have just done a demo, at least, you know, released a demo. To release a demo like what, a year later, after the game was released, that's just it just doesn't work. I for some reason a lot of Sony games have done that. Release a demo like long afterwards, like Metal Gear Solid 4 did that. There are a bunch of other games. Warhawk did that. You know, I don't know why they do that, but you know, releasing a demo after like long time after release. And not only that, patching it way after. You know, they patched the dual analog control way after. These are just bad marketing decisions. I'm not saying that, you know, the release of Lair should have made Factor 5 go under like it did. Factor 5 did go under, and it doesn't exist anymore as a company. But still, it's just really poor marketing decision, and this is why everyone ended up hating the game. I got Lair. I played Lair like I don't know, like 8 months after its release or so. You know, after reading about and hearing about everyone just hating on the game, you know, the thing that intrigues me is when everyone hates the game, I want to figure out if I hate the game too. So I had to try it out for myself, but I didn't have the willingness to spend like $60 and trying to find used game price for Lair that was reasonable was pretty hard at the time too, and at the time I didn't have a credit card to get a Blockbuster account to rent a game or whatever, so I was just like, what do I do? And so Lair is actually the game that led me to a service like Gamefly, which I still currently am subscribed to. So I got Gamefly. Lair turned out to be the first game I rented on Gamefly, and the end. What I found was that to me, Lair controls are actually pretty cool. I really like Lair with motion controls. I mean, if I was to play the game today and download the patch with the dual analog, whatever, I would still choose motion controls because I found it really immersive, really fluid. You know, controlling the dragon like you're actually having the reins is a pretty neat concept. And it works. I mean, there is a certain learning curve. One move where you like pull up the reins to do a 180 degree turn. That took me a while to kind of to perfect. Took me like 30 minutes or so. But after that, I had no problems at all. I know a lot of people had trouble with that 180 degree. You just gotta kind of go up and pull up like pretty gently. I think the controls, you really have to make just subtle movements. But I mean, that's just it's pretty logical the way the controls works. My biggest beeps with the game isn't the controls. I love the controls. And I'm not a big fan of much controls in majority of the games that it's in. You know, like Warhawk, Heavenly Sword especially, I hated Six Axis in that game. You know, but Lair, I actually really, really liked it. But that's not to say that Lair is an amazing game. I mean, it's kind of fun, and it's enjoyable, and you get an epic scale of the battlefield, and when you get that many dragons on screen or soldiers on screen, even though with like some texture popping issues here and there, it still looks pretty visually striking. But it's the level designs of this game is just really kind of in. I don't know, it really ruined the experience for me in a lot of ways because of just, it has like objectives going, you know, it has like, it's like, oh, take out this enemy while defending this dam, while doing this, while killing this very important enemy. There's like so many things going on at once, and there's not a really good targeting system. There's no map either to know where you're going. It's just kind of sloppy and very user unfriendly. You know, it could have been more kind of a game where it's more directed, you know, it's where you know what to do, where you can strategize a little more. In this game, it's just like, fly here, do whatever you can, and then maybe, like, fly over there and do whatever you can. It's not very structured well. And the structure, it gets really annoying because you have to kind of listen in to the audio cues to do what to do. And the audio dialogues that happen in-game, not during cutscenes, but in-game, are just awful. They're really badly acted, and they're looped. The voices repeat over and over again. It's really, really annoying. So, I mean, some levels. Like, there's this one, like, stealth mission, where you have to, like, avoid spotlights or whatever. I mean, if you hate the controls, that level is gonna, that's like the third mission. That level is just gonna make you stop playing right there. But I didn't have any problem with controls, so that level was actually pretty cool. I mean, when the level was structured like that, it was really cool. But in this open world, like, open landscape setting, where you have so many objectives to do, and it just didn't flow as well. There was way too many things going on. I mean, in some missions that was really cool, but in four of the later missions, it was just too much. I was failing missions again and again, and also like you have to do so many like motion waggling movements. When you're damaging a dam, you grab it and you shake the controller like crazy, and then while you're doing that, you have to destroy the navy that's around the dam, and then you have to protect the army that's behind you. It's just, you know, I mean, having that much stuff to do is intense, it's epic, but the basics, like a good targeting system where you can target, you know what you're targeting, you can change targets, no lock-on system. I mean, there is a lock-on, but it's hard to control. So that was really bad. And the storytelling is another thing as well. It's just, like, the cutscenes are, I guess, they're watchable, they're okay, but like after a mission you go back to the main menu and then there's a female narrator, kind of like in God of War, that kind of tells the story, whatever. But because you have to stay in the menu to listen to that, and what she says really isn't that enlightening, that kind of breaks the pace, and there isn't that much that happens in the story that's really like, it's all predictable. You know the main character is gonna end up, you know the side that the main character starts out with is the bad guy, and so like he changes sides, and you know, he goes AWOL, and he's not gonna come back as a hero to defeat the side that he was once fighting for. You know, it's pretty cliche. It's been done before, so you know, it's not that bad. I mean, it's not that interesting. Overall, I think Lair really tried to be too big for its own good. It tried to be way too epic, if you will. Tried to do too many things at one time in all 15 of its missions. I mean, yeah, and you know, if you really, really get to liking Lair, and there are a few that you know, believe me, there are a few that really, really, really like Lair. It's such a game that like really challenges you because of all the multiple objectives, and each mission is really different. It's about defending, it's about protecting, it's about bombing. There's a bombing mission. And there's three types of gameplay to be focused on. You're you when you get on the ground, you just mash buttons and your dragon just, you know, swipes, does flame, you know, breathes out flame, just kills enemy ground. So the ground part is really easy. There's no challenge to that at all. And then there's the flying around part, shooting stuff like your jet airplane shooting missiles or machine gun fire. There's that. And then there's also another part where if you encounter another dragon, your enemy dragon and your dragon are face to face, and then you have to time your button. You know, it's like a fighting game. You have to see right as the animation goes like this, you block, and you claw, and you do special attacks. So there's a fighting thing, there's the, you know, flying thing, and then there's the ground thing. So ground thing really is just button mashing. The ground thing is just cool to look at, but it's not really challenging at all. The most challenge is just figuring out where to go and what to do. It's all about prioritizing. You want to do figuring out, well, I want to protect the army right now, but then you don't want to spend too much time protecting the army because then you gotta destroy the town over there or protect the navy over there. There's a lot of things to take into account, and that might be one of the most enjoyable things about Lair, but it's also one of the most frustrating and annoying thing about Lair, because there's like no checkpoint. If you die in the mission, you pretty much have to start the mission over again. So it's just that's really my impression of Lair. It's not a horrible game by any chance, but it's just not that great of a game. Asking $60 for this game, and $60 was an asking price for this game, like for a year and a half. This price did not drop for a long time. I just think that wasn't fair. You know, because it's totally not a $60 game, not when it was released, and you know, it just wasn't. But so the price was a big thing. The fact that it didn't have a demo, the fact that it didn't give you an option with the controls, it really deserved a lot of flack for that. But the game itself, I thought it was pretty fun. The replay value it has, doesn't really exist unless you become a super hardcore fan of Lair. You can earn medals for how fast you beat it, how well you've done in the mission, but that's it. That's really the only replay value in this game, which, you know, I was done by like the 14th mission. I was like, jeez, you know, I failed the 14th mission like 4 times just because I had to protect the navy while trying to protect the other dragons, or shoot the other enemy dragons with the air fleet going on. There's always like 2 or 3 things going on at the same time, and I just thought that was a really bad design choice.